Thank you for watching this video from Kingsway Soft. Today, I will be introducing the SSIS Integration Toolkit for Directory Services. The SSIS Integration Toolkit for Directory Services is a cost-effective, easy-to-use, and high-performance data integration solution. It can be used to manipulate and process Windows Active Directory data utilizing the Microsoft SQL Server Integration Services SSIS capabilities. In today's demo, we will show you our software running in a SQL Server 2012 environment. If you are using a different SQL Server version, the interface will be slightly different. SSIS is capable to integrate directory services with virtually any other applications or database systems. To get started, let's create a simple SSIS project. This tutorial will assume that you already have the SSIS bits installed, otherwise you will not see the SSIS project type here. In the Business Intelligence template, select the Integration Services project and give your project a name. Press OK to create the solution. SSIS is a platform that can be used to implement data migration and application integration using its drag-and-drop capabilities. To begin the SSIS implementation using our toolkit, we will create a connection to Active Directory. Let's start by right-clicking the Connection Manager area and select the New Connection option. Select Active Directory and press Add. If you do not see this option, go back and make sure that our software is properly installed on your machine. In the General page, the Domain field lets you specify the domain name of the directory to connect to. The domain name should be the fully qualified name. You would now enter the credentials of the user account you would like to use when connecting to Active Directory. Note that this user would also need proper privileges. For the context bindings option, there are 6 options: negotiate, sealing, secure socket layer, server bind, signing, and simple bind. By default, negotiate, sealing, and signing are checked. You would specify the context binding according to your Active Directory setup. Before we hit OK, we should test the connection to make sure our information is correct and we can connect successfully. The next step is to use the Data Flow task to demonstrate the integration for Active Directory. If you are using SSIS 2012 or later, you should automatically see these Data Flow components in the toolbox of the Data Flow view. If you do not see any components, you can click the SSIS Toolbox button. Note that if you are using SSIS 2008 R2 or earlier, you will need to manually add these components to the SSIS Data Flow Toolbox. In the SSIS Toolbox, you will see the components from our SSIS Toolkit. The Active Directory Source component can be used to read or retrieve data from Active Directory. The Active Directory Destination component can be used to write data to Active Directory. Let's start with the Source component. First, we will drag the Active Directory Source component to the surface of our data flow. Double-click the component to bring up its editor form. Here we will first specify the Connection Manager. The Source Object option allows us to specify the Active Directory object to retrieve data from. The available objects include User, Group, and Computer. Notice that there is a Container Path option where you can specify the directory path that you want to narrow your search scope to. You may use the Search Criteria section to filter particular records according to your requirements. The Active Directory Search Criteria filter follows the Lightweight Directory Access Protocol, LDAP, filtering format. Let's navigate to the Columns page where we can specify which Active Directory fields we want to read data from. By default, all fields are selected. This may not be the best practice. You should only select the fields that you need to use in the downstream pipeline components. Note that it is possible to read data from custom attributes in Active Directory. To manually add the custom field, press the Add button. Specify the field name of the custom field you would like to read from. You can also specify the data type and length for your custom field. We're going to click the OK button to finish the configuration of this source component. For this demonstration, we're going to add a dummy data reader for the purpose of showing you how the data flows from the source to the destination component. Next, we'll create a new data flow task that demonstrates the Active Directory destination component. As mentioned before, the Active Directory destination component is used to write data to Active Directory. In our example today, we will update the address information stored in Active Directory for a particular user. To demonstrate this capability, we will use the data spawner as a source component to generate one row of record as the input. We will also use the premium derived column to add some hard-coded values. The data spawner and premium derived column components are part of our SSIS productivity pack, which contains a collection of premium SSIS components to enable greater developer productivity. Now let's drag the Active Directory destination component and connect to the upstream data flow component. On the general page, we must first select an Active Directory connection manager. The action option allows you to specify how data should be written to Active Directory. There are 5 supported action types available: create, update, delete, upsert, and move. Note that the upsert action will either update or create objects based on the primary key field, also known as the user principal name. The move action will move or rename an Active Directory object. For today's example, we will select update. The container path text box specifies the directory path in which you want to manipulate Active Directory data. Make sure to select the intended container path when configuring the destination component. If we navigate to the columns page, you will find that the fields are automatically mapped based on a name match. Similar to the source component, the destination component also allows us to write data to custom attributes in Active Directory by clicking on the Add button. Specify the field name of the custom field that you would like to write to. You can also specify the data type and length of your custom field. The last page is the error handling page, where there are 3 error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is fail on error, where the entire data flow will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the redirect rows to error output, where the error output will contain the failed records with extra columns: error code, error column, error message. These 3 error columns can usually help you identify why the error happened. The ignore error option is generally not recommended, as the component will stay silent for any errors that occur. There is also the enable columns for default output section, which you can use to enable or disable the additional column in the destination component's default output. The isNew option contains value to indicate whether it is a newly created record or an existing one. Click OK to finish configuring this destination component. This concludes a demonstration of our SSIS Integration Toolkit for directory services. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.